G'day ice cream lovers and welcome back to an action-packed episode of The Ice Cream Bloke. My name's Stevo and I'm telling you what, you'll need to be an ice cream lover to drop into the ice cream store that we're about to visit today. We're here in Jackson Hole, Wyoming, the playground of the rich and famous, standing in front of the famous Elk Antler Arch. We're about to visit a pretty interesting guy. He owns the place called Moos Ice Cream here in town. I'll tell you what, he's just about done it all. He's made sorbets, he's made ice creams, he's made Italian ices, and he's been a finalist on The Price is Right. So let's go and have a look inside at Moos Ice Cream.
The famous Elk Antler Arch welcomes visitors to the town of Jackson, Wyoming, where only a couple of blocks away is one of the nation's largest elk refuges. The town is encompassed by the mountain ranges of the Grand Tetons and gets about 3 to 4 million visitors every year. There's certainly a lot to do in town, particularly some great shopping in downtown's boardwalk area. And not far down the boardwalk, we hit the Beaver Creek Hat Company, which is home to some great furry hats and Moos Gourmet ice cream.
Okay, folks, well, we're here back in Moos, and we're in the back of Beaver Creek Hat and Leather. And as you can see, I've already made my purchase. Very stylish. We've got Vicky here. How are you? And this is now Roderick or Rod?
Rick.
Okay. 2 out of 3 ain't bad. Now, tell us a little bit about Moos Ice Cream, Rick.
We manufacture 100% all organic, all natural ice cream. Sorbet. All of our ice creams are made pure product, old school technology. We don't add any fillers or colors, extracts, gums, carrageenan, about any of our ice creams. All of our sorbets are diabetic dietetic. All diabetics are not allowed to have them. They're very low sugar. They're all vine ripe fruits. And that is it. Now, you have to add 1% cane sugar on some of them that don't get the sugar content up quite up to snuff, but they still all lay in underneath 3 grams of sugar to a half cup soda.
Now, you were saying you're quite the authority on fruit and stuff. We had a little bit of your mango sorbet.
Right.
And you were saying that you know the background of the best mangoes in the world, right?
Correct.
Do you want to give us the spiel on the best mangoes in the world? I love that.
There's 25 different varieties of mangoes in the world. The top one, which is the Alfonso mango, which grows out of India. And then we have the Carabao mango that grows around the Fiji, Indonesia, Thailand area. Those are the two only acceptable mangoes that we use in our sorbets. They don't have a bitterness aftertaste. They're just smooth all the way through with a nice, rich, robust flavor.
Let's get some of that mango sorbet out.
Okay, salad.
Get this big bundle of cash out of the way. That's what you pay the ice cream bloke for coming and featuring ice cream on the... that's not true. That's just
during the winter time, we serve in half-gallon containers. We don't have quite the business that we do in the summertime that we have in the winter. So keep everything really nice and fresh. We serve them in a little smaller container. That way, the customers always got the perfect product in their mouth.
This is one of the best mango sorbets I've ever eaten. And that's saying also something very interesting is you've been on The Price is Right.
I have been.
You won the Grand Showcase or whatever it's called.
Yeah, the Showcase Showdown.
That's exciting.
That happened back in December.
And what did you win?
A piano, 7-piece living room set, a trip to London, England, which I look forward to taking quite soon.
Mm-hmm. And what was the final price of the Grand, whatever you call it?
The $23,000 total.
Tell me now, so far as ice cream is concerned, how many flavors do you run, usually?
During the wintertime, we just try keeping 16 in the cabin, keep it fresh. Summertime, we skip 32 flavors daily.
Mm-hmm.
I make a total of 189 flavors of ice cream and a total of 38 flavors of sorbets.
Wow. And what's the most unusual ice cream you've ever made?
Well, there's too many to count. There's several of them out there. Rare ones, when we use olive oil ice creams. Mm-hmm. Mixing several different fruits into it, concoctions.
Tell us a little bit about...
Granny apple, black pepper sorbet. I mean, we get a lot of different fruits. We use lulu, wanabana.
Wanabana?
Wanabana, which is a sour sop.
A sour sop, because for me, one almond up was all one almond up. Is that the same kind of thing?
Yeah. And actually, we made lucuma last year, which is a fruit out of Peru, and it was really popular. We get so many tourists through here that are from different places abroad.
Where do you access these crazy fruits from all over the world?
I've been working around brokers for the last 15 years.
Is that right?
Secrets contained in a lock safe. Right there,
man. That's the lock safe. What about, what are some of the other interesting ice creams that you have going here? Like today?
Today we have a chocolate cabernet sauvignon ice cream. We have a fresh roasted banana, a gingerbread.
Let's do a fresh roasted banana.
Let's get some more spoons.
We'll need some more spoons. We have a dirty spoon thing. Now, you were also saying that you sell to restaurants and so forth around the place?
Yeah, we do all fine dining establishments. Mm-hmm. Jackson Hole, willing to pay the extra premium price for the ice cream and the quality of ice cream. And we also sell in local grocery stores here, local Albertsons of Freetown.
Very, very good. Hey, now another thing too is, do you make all your own candies and so forth?
Yeah, we make all our own chocolate. Right?
Wow.
And pastries in the summertime, we do lots of cookies and brownies, and fudges, and other types of pastries. During the summertime. Wintertime, we don't do them just because it's such a dry climate up here that we basically have a one-day shelf life before it turns into the top.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. The moisture just gets sucked right out of our pastry, so we don't have enough volume of people to keep things really moving here in the winter. In the summertime, we do a plentiful supply.
I actually manage to pick out another for his mom and dad. So
okay.
That keeps him, but like when he goes away or whatever,
Well, I think it's a great combination. Woolly hats and ice cream.
Yeah.
Does it look good on me?
It looks awesome on you.
Your wife said you looked adorable.
That's right. Well, I tell you what, from Rod and Vicky here at Moos Ice Cream, do you have a website?
Moos1west.net.
That's email.
Oh, email. But no website. But you can email me and I will be glad to ship you ice cream on dry ice.
You can also go to teamsuppressor.com and see him on his paintball site.
We'll do that. In fact, we'll load all of that information onto our website, which is theicecreambloke.com. From Vicky and Rod, Rick, here at Moos.
Roderick on The Price is Right. We had to use our big names on our driver's license. It was Roderick and Victoria. We were like,
Well, from Roderick and Victoria here at Moos, we'd like to say thank you very much. It's been very enlightening. If you're ever up in Jackson Hole, come and see them. That's it for this week. Keep on scooping. We'll see you next week.
Gotcha.
Thank you so much.
Now, tell you have two great loves. One is ice cream. The other is, apart from Vicky. apart from Vicky.
I play professional paintball.
Now, what?
Travel the world.
What? Now, I didn't even
know.
The professional paintball. You travel around the world.
Playing paintball.
And you get paid to do this?
We're sponsored up, yeah. Don't make a lot of money at it, but I don't have to pay a lot of money to play.
Can I say I'm a paintball widow?
You're a paintball widow. Have you been shot a couple of times? That's what I want to know.